What's splashing the soldier the game spitter? Yoshi, you already know some of the streets happy that you got these first degree murder charges upon you. Some of the streets, you know, they upset because they want you on the streets so they can put that RP beside your name. You already know how it is. You got half of the streets, the people that not, when I say half of the streets, I ain't talking about the whole band room. I'm talking about the people that's in tune with you or, you know, got a problem with you, issue with you, or they can run into you. You know, half of them, yeah, they is scared of you. And even with the scared of you part, you got different kind of fears of you. You got one scared where they trying to avoid you. Then you got the other scared where they going to down you too. If they catch you, they can catch you slipping, they going to down you. But they scared of you. You got to understand, Yoshi, there's a lot of dudes that was in prison that was scared of other dudes, but they don't ever really show it. But they really scared to fight. But that's why they'll win, because they so they don't want to lose. And they scared. Or they'll stab them down real quick and come up out the situation because they were scared. And they just thought real quick and they was on their toes. They sobered up and everything. They got really got on their P's and Q's. You see what I'm saying? So you is a threat. You know, some guys, they scared of you. They just scared of your trigger finger. Not, you know what I'm saying? Not you personally. And then you got the other ones that is. They don't want no smoke. They don't want no one-on-one with you. They don't want no gunplay with you. But from the circumstances of who they tied in with, BBG, NBA, 4KT, other little sets, affiliated little sets, you know, they got to be involved in the situation, but they don't want no problem with you. They really like your style and wish you wouldn't even like that, but they can't, you know, show that though. So when you got a lot of fear like that, when you in a situation like that, ain't no telling which fear you're going to run into, let alone all of them at the same time. You facing, you going up against all of them at the same time. Then you got the ones that, you know, that's kind of, they got a little fear, they're kind of scared, and they don't play by the rules the same way that black gang members or black street guys do. You know, they basically going to go by the art of war rules. Take my enemy down by any means necessary. If you ain't fighting that war or that battle the same way he is, you'll lose. So they might got a call. Yeah, I seen them. Oh, you want me to say we seen them shoot or we seen them in the area? Oh, yeah, we into it. He did come shoot up this spot. Or, yeah, he is moving these type of work. Or he do got these guns in his house. He got two goddamn stolen AR-15 right now in the house. He got Dracos and everything in there. Might got a bulletproof vest in there. Yeah, he might got switches on his clocks and though. I'm telling you, he can have all that though. You see what I'm saying? So you might got that. And it just gets you out of the way because you're a headache. Because you're really sneaky. Like a lot of gangsters can think that you more sneaky than you is fear. Like, the reason why you got all this rank because you sneaky with it. You know, so you real slick with it. Not saying you ain't about that versus, like, you just no weapons, no status, and niggas just scared of you. Because, yo, you know, your energy in the room. It might not be that. It might just be that you hard to find. And but for them, they not hard to find. You running down on them and you ain't scared to run down on them and you ain't scared to fight and all that duh. You see what I'm saying? So different gangsters got different thoughts. And all these gangsters can be in the same crew. So one member can think this way and say, talk like this, talk so crazy. The other member know that he pie. Know he's sweet and he'll still talk, but you already know that you handle, you didn't see him a couple of times, you done checked him and everything. But it'll still be believable because he's still around real ones that'll bring it to you, that'll bring that same type of war, that same type of static that you want, they'll bring it to you, but they ain't a mix of dudes that scared of you. They hanging with dudes that's, you know what I'm saying? So they don't got a straight, sturdy crew, a straight niggas that's ready to take you to war. They ain't going back down from nothing. Yeah, they want you on the streets, they don't want no, yeah, so. These are the cards that's going to get played out. These are situations that you're going to be having to go through throughout your life. You know what I'm saying? You're going to have to beat the feds every blue moon. You're going to run into state charges. They're going to upgrade. It looked like it's petty. They gave you a $200,000 bond. If you'd have been in Charlotte, that would have been an easy $1 million bond. The mother seven attempts, that must ain't hold a lot of weight, or they knew you was going to beat that. They probably seen that you was going to beat 5 out of 7, or you was going to beat 6 out of 7. And then the one or the two wasn't going to hold that much weight. 5 years, take a plea, 5 years, 3 years, you know what I'm saying? And you back out. So they nah, they already got a witness. It's probably a little bit of evidence they got. They already got an informant. Hey, he 1 foot in, 1 foot out. So they might as well, we might as well go ahead and pull him in, at least on these murder charges. We can sit him in here for like a couple years. That'll buy you more time to think about it, to go through with it. You know what I'm saying? Buy you more time with your career. You know, do so much, because if you get exposed, it could be over. It could be dangerous too. So yeah, they could buy you more time so we can have him sit in the county. You know what I'm saying? But we can't, we got to give him a bond because it's like the evidence that we got is not strong enough. You know what I'm saying? They really had some real, like, yeah, we seen him. We got him on tape. We pinged his cell phone. that bond would have been a little bit more higher, especially bouncing off of a 7-attempt murder. You know what I'm saying? Like, they would have gave him at least $1 million bond, $500,000, not $200,000. Come on, man. But so that's what that is on that. They probably got an informant or they got a witness that's 1 foot in, 1 foot out. One day they real confident, they gonna, you know, put you away. Next minute, something happened in the streets where they get scared, they get shook again, or they could just have a change of heart, or they don't feel like that no more. You see what I'm saying? Gangsters go through that too. They have a change of heart, like, nah, you know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna testify. I changed my mind. And yeah, so they still, that's still enough for the judge and people them to let them pursue with the charges and charge you with it. You know what I'm saying? Just to pull you off the streets. You see what I'm saying? They might want to pull you off the streets too and save you, because young boy off. They might want y'all to hit or, you know, get both of them, get both of y'all in a situation. So they might pull you off while they got young boy off, pull you off too, or other, you know what I'm saying, real important BBG or NBA members that's not on the streets right now. Pull them off. They off the streets, pull you off too, because you don't want you to get ate up by a no name. Or they don't want you to be keep killing a no name. They get the evidence and they lock you up. It could be that. A lot of different scenarios. So they, yeah, while they gone, might as well knock you out. So when young boy come back or another top NBA or BBG member or 4KT member come back on the streets, then they'll let you back out. Then, you know, so a lot of people can speculate.